A long time ago, there lived a wicked, heartless King Kamsa. He ruled the city of Mathura, which was then the capital of the Yadava kingdom. Kamsa was a very cruel ruler. He imprisoned his own father in order to become the king. He had a sister named Devaki, who was married to Vasudeva. One day, a divine voice from the skies warned Kamsa that the eighth son born to Devaki and Vasudeva would be responsible for his death. Fearing that this prediction would come true, Kamsa threatened to kill his sister at once. But everybody at the kingdom pleaded with him to spare her life. Finally, he agreed to spare her on the condition that every child born to Devaki and Vasudeva be killed by him at birth. So, the merciless Kamsa kept Devaki and Vasudeva imprisoned in a cell and posted many soldiers on guard. In the next few years, Devaki gave birth to 6 children. Each time a child was born, the guards would inform Kamsa. Although Devaki and Vasudeva cried helplessly and begged for mercy every time, Kamsa would kill the newborn child immediately. Many years passed this way. Now it was time for the 7th child to be born. This time, the gods knew that the child had to be saved because he too would have to play a part in the killing of Kamsa. The gods therefore magically shifted the baby into the hands of a woman named Rohini, who lived in Vrindavan in the house of the village chief Nanda and his wife Yashoda. Kamsa was told that the baby had died. This boy grew up to be Balrama, Krishna's older brother. Soon, it was time for the 8th child to be born. Kamsa knew it was this child that the voice had warned him about. He was anxious. He ensured that Devaki and Vasudeva were in chains and even ordered many more soldiers to guard the cell. He even arranged for elephants, dogs, and lions to stand guard around the cell. Yet, when Krishna, the divine child, was born, all Kamsa's measures went in vain. The child did not cry, and mysteriously, the chains that bound Devaki and Vasudeva broke loose. The guards fell asleep, and so did all the elephants, dogs, and lions. A divine voice from above told Vasudeva to take the baby to Vrindavan, to the house of the chieftain Nanda, whose wife Yashoda had just given birth to a baby girl. The voice instructed that the two babies be exchanged. The doors of the prison opened magically and Vasudeva set out. It was a dark and stormy night, accompanied by a heavy downpour. Vasudeva needed to cross the river Yamuna to get to Vrindavan, and the journey seemed unsafe and frightening. But the gods from above soon intervened. The baby stretched out his foot from the basket and placed it in the water, and instantly the waves grew calm and the water receded, enabling Vasudeva to walk across the river with ease. Vasudeva soon came to Vrindavan, where everybody was fast asleep. At Nanda's house, he found a baby girl who slept next to Yashoda. Vasudeva replaced this baby with Krishna and quickly started his journey back. Vasudeva's return journey was easy. He got back inside the prison and placed the baby girl next to Devaki. The baby began to cry, waking up the guards, the elephants, the lions and the dog. The guards immediately rushed to inform Kamsa. Kamsa rushed to the prison and grabbed the baby by her legs in order to smash her against a rock. But the baby took the form of a goddess and declared to Kamsa that the one destined to kill him had already been born. After stating this, the baby simply vanished. Kamsa had also been told that the child destined to kill him would be a cowherd. So, he sent his spies to Vrindavan, which was a village of cowherds, to find out if a baby had been born on the same night. His spies reported to the king that a baby boy had indeed been born to the chieftain's wife on the very same day. Kamsa ordered the demons to set out and take Krishna's life. The first of these was Putana, a she-demon who took the form of a young lady. After meeting Krishna and becoming friendly, Putana, using her charm and words, tried to feed Krishna poisoned milk. Krishna drank the milk, but it had absolutely no effect on him. Instead, it was Putana that died. Next, a demon tried to crush Krishna under a cart full of pots, but Krishna kicked the cart back at the demon, killing it. Was from a wind demon. He snatched Krishna out of his mother's lap and created a great storm. Krishna used his immense power to toss the demon up in the air and smash him against a rock. In this way, Krishna's extraordinary power and strength became known to the world, even as he was a little child. But at the same time, Krishna was the mischievous, naughty little brat of the village. Krishna would cunningly steal handfuls of butter and curd from the mud pots hung in people's homes and feast on them. He found great joy in breaking pots full of water that were being carried by young village girls. And guess what? He even stole the clothes of young girls as they went to bathe in the river. As he grew up, Krishna became the idol of the village that everybody looked up to. In every difficult situation, Krishna stood by the people, supporting them. Once, when the heavy rains refused to recede for days on end, Krishna lifted up the great mountain of Govardhan with his little finger, and the grateful crowds took shelter underneath it. But Kamsa had not forgotten Krishna, as he had been told that it was Krishna who was going to kill him. Krishna was ultimately successful in killing the cruel king Kamsa. He soon set all prisoners free, and his parents were once again the rightful inheritors of the throne. Krishna and Balrama stayed on in Mathura. Peace returned to the kingdom and all the people were happy. In time, both Balrama and Krishna married, had children, and lived happily for many, many years.